Hey everybody, how's it going? Welcome back to Fight Focus.
And for today's video, we will be covering WWE moves that were used in pro MMA fights.
Also, if you enjoy this video, please make sure to drop a like, subscribe, and comment what video you want to see next. Let's get to it.
Watching incredible athletes perform awe-inspiring maneuvers is one of several reasons so many people enjoy the genre of entertainment that is professional wrestling. While the results may be predetermined, most of us know by now that the men and women performing can and often do suffer serious injuries. Of course, many of these injuries are the result of a maneuver being executed incorrectly or even poor timing. However, what most wrestling fans don't know is whether or not the moves they watch their favorite WWE superstars perform week in and week out would actually work in a live combat situation. Believe it or not, over the years there have been several professional mixed martial artists who have used patented WWE finishers to hurt their opponents, and in some cases even win their respective fights. So without further ado, this is WWE moves that were used in pro MMA fights. Number 10, the Rock Bottom. The Rock Bottom is a finisher popularized by the most electrifying man in sports entertainment, Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Booker T also used his own version of the move, which was dubbed the Book End. The maneuver essentially involves grasping the opponent's shoulders, hoisting them in the air or having them jump, and then dropping them on their back. In 1998, at Extreme Challenge 22, a mixed martial artist by the name of Travis Fulton decided to use a modified version of the Rock Bottom against a local martial arts teacher named Jeremy the Taekwondo Kid Bullock. It worked remarkably well. Fulton, who would go on to have a respectable career, made short work of the Taekwondo Kid. In fact, he literally picked up Bullock up off the mat, hoisted him in the air, and proceeded to execute a Rock Bottom that would make the People's Champ tip his cap. The move actually earned Fulton a TKO victory. Moreover, his opponent had to be carted off on a stretcher. Fortunately, the Taekwondo instructor would go on to make a full recovery. Number 9, the Moonsault. The moonsault has become a fairly common move in modern day professional wrestling. Over the years, it's been used as a finisher by several stars, including Lita and Belle DeMott. A moonsault is basically a backflip that can be performed from either a standing position or off the top rope. Yes, someone actually did a moonsault in an MMA fight. That individual is current UFC welterweight Michael Pereira. Pereira, who is known for using an unorthodox offense, executed multiple moonsaults in his February 2019 bout with Daesung Kim. While the maneuver didn't do a ton of physical damage in itself, it clearly left Kim bewildered and susceptible to some great follow-up shots. Moreover, and perhaps more importantly, Pereira's unique assault made for an excellent highlight reel package, which helped earn him a UFC contract. Number 8, the Pile Driver. Legends like Jerry the King Lawler and Harley Race used the pile driver to finish off several opponents over the course of their Hall of Fame careers. A pile driver involves holding an opponent upside down with their head between one's legs and falling often in a seated position toward the canvas. The move can be quite dangerous and was banned from WWE in 2000 unless a wrestler, The Undertaker, is granted special permission to use it. More recently, at a 2015 World Series of Fighting event, Chris Foster pulled up a well-executed pile driver to try and thwart his opponent Chris Foster's takedown attempt. Though it shouldn't be used, the old-school pro wrestling hold has made an appearance in multiple MMA bouts. Number 7, the Flying Armbar. The Flying Armbar, or Cross Arm Breaker, was former WWE champ Alberto Del Rio's finisher of choice. Of course, Del Rio is also a mixed martial artist who took on former UFC light heavyweight champion Tito Ortiz at Combat America's 51 a few years back. Though Del Rio added a bit of flair to the move for entertainment purposes, the Flying Armbar can be an effective MMA hold. Just ask former UFC flyweight champion Demetrius Mighty Mouse Johnson. Back in 2017, at UFC 216, Johnson was set to defend his title against Ray Borg. In the fifth round of the contest, the flyweight legend managed to submit Borg with a beautifully executed Flying Armbar. Johnson's win earned him a Submission of the Year honors from several high-profile news outlets including MMA Mania and Sherdog. Mighty Mouse proved that the Cross Arm Breaker can also get the job done inside an UFC octagon. Number 6, the Dropkick. The Dropkick is one of the most commonly utilized moves in sports entertainment. However, it has also been used as a finisher from time to time. Attitude Era superstar Hardcore Holly used to polish off his opponents with the maneuver. More recently, Gentleman Jack Gallagher has been dropkicking his way to victory. In the early days of MMA, there were a few fighters who actually tried landing a dropkick in the cage. For the most part, they ended up on the mat with their opponent pummeling them after failing to connect. That being said, popular Japanese fighter and pro wrestler Ikuhisa Minoa successfully landed the move in a 2006 bout with Eric Butterbean Esch. Yes, the very same Butterbean that fought Bart Gunn at WrestleMania 15. While Minoa's well-executed dropkick wasn't enough to take the big man out, it did manage to send Butterbean backward and stagger him a bit. Given the fact that Esch is listed at over 400 pounds, the Japanese star's attempt would definitely qualify as successful. Number 5, DDT. The DDT is a move that was popularized by WWE Hall of Famer Jake the Snake Roberts, who used it to put away quite a few wrestlers in his heyday. The maneuver consists of putting an opponent in a front face lock and driving them headfirst into the canvas. Surprisingly, the DDT was successfully used against the greatest female fighter of all time, Amanda the Lioness Nunes. Back in 2014, at UFC 178, Nunes took on former title challenger Alpha Cat Zingano. During the contest, the Alpha Cat managed to pull off a DDT worthy of Roberts himself. Instead of releasing her opponent after hitting the maneuver, Zingano used her momentum to gain a dominant position and wound up on top of Nunes. Nunes would end up losing the fight via third round TKO. Of course, she hasn't lost since and is in the midst of an 11 fight win streak in which she has captured two UFC titles. However, on that evening back in 2014, she was no match for Cat Zingano in her devastating DDT. Number 4. Sweet Chin Music. Sweet Chin Music, also known as the Super Kick, is a high-impact move that the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels used to capture several WWE championships. The Super Kick is essentially a high-side thrust kick that lands on an opponent's chin or another part of their head. Back in November of 2014, flyweight standout Louis Smolka faced Richie Vasulik at UFC Fight Night Rockhold vs Bisping. Early in the third round, Smolka landed a nasty super kick that sent Vasulik to the canvas. In this instance, the move was not only successful, it ultimately led to a KO victory for Smolka. Evidence would suggest that Michael's signature move can also be an effective finisher inside the UFC octagon as well. Number 3. The Powerbomb. Over the years, the Powerbomb has been a popular finishing move among big men like Kevin Nash, Sid Justice, and even The Undertaker for a period. These days, current WWE superstars Kevin Owens uses a modified version of the move to get his hand raised. In his prime, Quentin Rampage Jackson was justifiably one of the most feared men in the sport of mixed martial arts. One of the many reasons for this reputation was his remarkable win over Ricardo Arona during his stint with Pride back in 2004. It was during this fight that Rampage found a very effective maneuver. Before Arona could get the submission cinched in, Jackson essentially deadlifted the opponent over his head before ultimately sending him crashing to the mat with a slightly modified version of the powerbomb. Arona was rendered unconscious and the referee quickly stepped in to stop the fight. Number 2. The Chokeslam. The chokeslam is perhaps most commonly associated with WWE superstars such as The Big Show and Kane, both of whom use the maneuver to end more than a few matches. As moves go, it's fairly straightforward and involves grasping an opponent's throat, hence the choke part, hoisting him or her into the air and then slamming them into the mat. As one might imagine, it's not particularly easy to pull off in a legitimate combat situation. That being said, former UFC light heavyweight Houston the Assassin Alexander managed to do it. In 2007, Alexander went one-on-one with Thiago Silva at UFC 78. During the contest, the Assassin managed to pin Silva against the cage and deliver a big show-like chokeslam to the Brazilian. The slam did manage to get Silva to the mat, but it wasn't enough to secure the victory. Silva would soon recover and win the fight via first-round TKO. Number 1. The Walls of Jericho. The Boston Crab has long been a popular submission hold in professional wrestling. Back in the day, Rick the Model Martel used it to close out matches. In recent years, the Crab has been associated with former WWE champ Chris Jericho, who uses a slightly modified version of the hold, dubbed the Walls of Jericho. While an extremely painful hold, the Boston Crab is very difficult to apply to an opponent who is resisting. Difficult, but not impossible, as a British fighter named John O'Meara's proved to the world. Back in 2017, at a full contract contender event, or FCC, a pair of little-known fighters named John O'Meara's and Aaron Jones were set to do battle. After a somewhat awkward scramble on the mat, Mears managed to secure both his opponent's legs and submit Jones using the Boston Crab. This would go down as the first Boston Crab victory in professional mixed martial arts bout. And that right there concludes our list.
Alright MMA fans, thank you so much for sticking around to the end of this video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like, make sure to hit the notification bell, and don't forget to subscribe if you're new. Also, don't forget to comment below what video you want to see next.